Hello everyone, welcome to Shelter. This is a game where you play as a mother badger protecting her cubs. I don't think there's much more to say about it than that. Yeah, I need to protect my cubs, and just FYI, there is going to be heartbreak. I'm going to try to protect them, obviously. That is my duty, that is my job. But in all likelihood, some of my cubs are going to be taken away. They're going to die. It's depressing to think about, but that's in the future. For now, everything is fine. For now, no one's dead yet. Oh god, my poor cubs. I'm even going to name them. I'm definitely going to name them, which is going to make it even harder when they get killed. But anyway, yes, that's in the future. And just right off the bat, I'd like to say that I really like just the ambience created by the scene here in the menu. Just, you know, all the leaves and stuff falling down and the music, which is kind of calm and kind of chill, kind of depressing, sort of. Just the whole look of this and the music just makes me think of time passing, you know, and the seasons changing and just life going on. Okay, well, let's get into it. New game. Okay, well, I've never started before. I have no idea what I'm doing. Aw, look at the little cubs. They're so cute. And they all follow me. Is that one dead? It's not moving. Okay, what is it to do stuff? It's like E? Space? God, they're so cute, aren't they? Okay, I've gotta name them pretty soon. Alright, I'm gonna check out the controls so I know what I'm doing, and I'm going to name them, so I'll be right back. Okay, I have returned, and I have named all of my beautiful little cubs, based on the look of the design on their back. Alright, so let's go over them, and I've actually written down pictures of their designs, so when I inevitably forget some of them, I will be able to remind myself. Okay, I can't point, unfortunately. Yes I can. Okay, here we go. Okay, this one is Tank, because it kind of vaguely reminds me of a tank for some reason. This one is Flash, because it looks kind of like a racing stripe or something, so fast, so I went with Flash, so Tank, Flash. This is Beetle, because it's got that stripe going down the whole center, so it kind of looks like a beetle. This one is Frosty, not because it's cold, but because it looks like it's been frosted. And this one, which I'm hoping is just asleep and not dead, I'm going to name Star, because it kind of looks like a shooting star. So let me make sure I have them down. Tank, Flash, Beetle, Frosty, and Star. Okay. I'm going to forget those, but I'm sure by the end of this I will remember them. Alright, let's see if we can wake Star up. And you bark by pressing left mouse button. And it causes all of your cubs to bark back to you. So you can hear where they're at, I guess, if you lose track of them. God, they're adorable, aren't they? Just listen to them. Alright, so let's see if we can wake Star up. Okay, that's not good. Is it asleep or is it dead? I mean, I don't think I can do anything other than bark. I think it might be dead. Alright, let's explore the rest of the burrow. God, I just love the way they waddle. They're so cute. Oh, is that some food? Oh! Do we need to bring in food? I'm coming, Star. Good morning. Here's your breakfast in bed. Wake up? Star? I mean, it's a different color from us. Almost like it's dead. Oh, there we go! Star! Yes, Star's alive! Okay, now it's a normal color. Okay, it was just asleep. Okay, so Star, Flash, Frosty, Beetle, and Tank. Come on, my cute little cubs. Okay, I love this game already. I'm just gonna keep barking. They're so cute. Look at the way they waddle. Okay, where are we going? Looks like I'm going further into the burrow. There was another way to go, one that led out to, like, a waterfall or something. Is this leading anywhere? Ooh, it's a little pathway. Hold on, I just want to get a really close look at them. Look at them! Okay, hold on. It's gonna be hard to keep these two straight because they look very similar. Which one's which? This one's Star, right? And this one's Flash? The main difference is that one has like a band around its lower body, whereas the other one doesn't. Okay, yeah, this one's... Well, actually, wait. No, this one's Flash. According to the designs I wrote down, yeah, this one's Flash. That one's Star. Okay. Yeah, that one's Flash. Hey, Beetle. Hey, Tank. Come on. Here we are into the open world. Okay, shift to sprint. Formation, my cubs! Man, this game is really beautiful. It's such a strange art style, one that I've never seen before, and I don't even know if there's a particular name for this art style. Kind of, you know, it almost makes me think of paper mache. Especially with the way all the trees are, if you look at these. You know, it kind of looks like paper mache to me. It's really cool. Beautiful. Left click to pick up food. It is a beautiful day. Let's pick up some food. There we go. Okay, so do I get to choose, like, who I want to... Oh, look at them. They're all eager. Do I get to, Oh, I can even zoom in and out with the scroll wheel. Do I get to choose who I want to give it to, or can they, like, all eat it? Okay, well, Star just has some to eat. So, let's give some to Flash. Okay, I gave it to the wrong one. Oh well, it's fine. Actually, wait, I just gave it to Star again, didn't I? I did! Star... Ugh. Freaking Star got fed 2 times in a row. You greedy little bastard. It's okay, though. I still love you. Alright, let's stay zoomed in. These badgers are so cute. Oh, you can ram trees to get food down from them. Alright, here we go. Ugh. Alright. Star's already gotten fed 2 times. So this time, Flash. There you go. Oh, do you actually cause this to ripple when you walk through it? You do. Cool. Nice attention to detail. This is a seriously beautiful game. You know, when I saw the screenshots for it, I actually thought it didn't look very good. The art style was interesting, but I thought it looked kind of ugly, but now that I'm actually seeing it in motion, I really like it. Although I do find the fact that it's super, super low contrast and everything's all washed out, I do find that very strange. I'd like to see what it would look like with more contrast, to see whether it'd be better or not, but it is strangely low contrast. But other than that, it's very beautiful. Alright, let's find some more food. If I stay zoomed out, I can see my cubs better. Wait, where did they go? Cubs? Oh, okay, they're hidden in here. Whew! Yeah, more situational awareness when I'm zoomed out. More comfortable to control my character when I'm zoomed in. I'm gonna stay zoomed out a bit, so I can see my lovely little cubs. There's another tree. Let's go grab some food. Yeah! Okay, who's gonna get fed this time? Flash already got fed. Star already got fed. Let's feed Frosty. There you go, Frosty. I don't suppose I can eat flowers? No, didn't think so. So I'm guessing these, like, bushes that I'm in right now are probably used to hide from things. That's my guess, because they look like very good cover. Alright, I see another tree over there. Let me check around here for any tubers or whatever it is that I'm eating. Out of the ground. Don't see anything. Can they keep up with me if I sprint? No, they can't. Okay, so if you sprint, you get separated from them. Oh, and there's a tree. Oh, two. Oh, God, they both ate. Oh, who just ate? It was Flash and Star again. They have been overfed. Star has now been fed three times. Okay, I need to make sure they're further away before I bump the tree down. Well, at the moment, it's a very relaxing game. But as soon as the dangers start appearing, I'm guessing that's going to change. Ooh, there's a little cave in there. Let's explore around here first, though. So what is my goal for today? Is it just to, like, feed everyone once? Oh, there's something I can grab. Okay. Time to give this to someone else. Alright, hold on. Who do I give it to? Who have I fed? I know I fed Flash... I fed Flash, Star, and Frosty, so I need Tank and Beetle. Okay, here you go, Beetle. Tank is next. Left click to catch frogs. Oh, you can catch frogs? Cool. Oh, there's one. Come here. Here we go. Oh, Beetle. I mean, Tank. Tank is you. Here you go, Tank. All right, everyone's been fed once. Success. Now, let's go check out the cave before I cross. Actually, let's go check out what's over here. the far end before I go into the cave or across. Don't think there's anything here. Nope. Okay, let's go check out the cave. Come on, my lovelies. Wait, where was the cave? Is it to my right or to my left? I think it's over here. Yeah, here we go. Keep up! Oh, here we go. Alright. Well, Star has been fed 3 times, so no to you, and Flash has been fed 2x. So, let's feed... Oh god, they're really close together. Let's feed Frosty. Oh, I'm behind the waterfall now. Actually, this is probably going to take me to the other side. Yeah, that's the direction I'm going in. Right, another frog. Where are you? There you are. And gotcha. Okay. Let's give it to Tank. Yeah, here you go, Tank. Can I go in the water? No. Oh, here we go. Let's headbutt this. Okay. Who do I give it to? How about Beetle? Yeah, I'm gonna give it to Beetle. Here you go. I think at this point they've all been fed 2x, I think. Oh, here we go. I know Star's been fed 3 times. Let's go with Beetle, again. Alright, looks like there's no frogs around here. Come on, let's continue. This looks dangerously open. I'm worried about hawks. Oh, ah. Who was that? That's Tank. Okay, that's fine. I'm gonna feed Flash next. I gotta get there before them. Okay, Flash. Which is you. There you go, Flash. It's interesting that there's no, like, food meter. Like, there's... At the moment, there's really no gamey stuff at all. There's no health, there's no food meter, there's no objective. Like, I know I need to feed them. And I need to support them. I don't know... Like, there's no exact amount. Which is actually interesting. That's an interesting design decision, and I think a good one. Because I don't need to know. I don't need something gamey like, you know, feed each one 3 times to complete the level sort of thing. I don't need that. I know I need to support them, and I need to feed them, so I'm just going to feed them as much as possible. Butterfly. Oh, here we go. All right, let's do Frosty next, which is you. God, they're adorable, aren't they? Headbutt, here we go. Okay, again, Star already has 3 feedings, so let's just start from the top again. Let's go with Beetle. The camera is a little bit funky. I wish it didn't go through stuff so much like this. Like, it just clips through a lot of things. So the camera could definitely be improved, but it's okay. It's decent. It's good enough. Alright, Flash is next. There you go. Catch up. Oh, so you can hide in cover and get rodents. Like this. Very cool. Okay, just fed Flash, so Tank is next. There you go. Eat up, gotta get your strength. What is that? Is that anything? Nope, just a pile of dirt, I guess. Oh no, oh god, which one got it? Tank. Ooh, Tank got overfed. Alright, it's not a big deal. Wait a minute. Whoa, hold on, that's, Star? That's Star, right? Star is looking kind of... like the color of, his or her coat is all light, like the one that I fed back in the beginning. Does that mean... oh, that means it needs to be fed. Okay, okay. So they all need to be constantly fed, gotcha, okay. Alright, well, Star is getting fed next. Because Star got overfed in the beginning, but it's been a really long time. Oh, birds. Are those the kind that are going to take... are those hawks? Are they going to take my cubs? Or are they nice birds? The kind of birds that eat, like, fruit and nuts. I like those kinds of birds. Man, this game is really beautiful. It is a very strange art style, but somehow it just really works. Oh wow, that tree is coming out. It's about to fall over. The roots are just barely keeping it in. Alright, we gotta keep going. Alright, here we go. Here we go, Star. You're gonna be fine, Star. There you go. Okay, you're good now. Oh, that's a fox. Or is it? Is that a fox? I think it's a fox. I need to actually attack it? I thought we'd have to avoid it. Okay, I guess I need to chase it away. Where did it go? I really like how the music's responding to what's happening. Like, now it's getting more exciting because of the chase. Very responsive music to what you're doing. Where did it go? There it is. All right, let's go hide. Come on, cubs. Come on, come on, come on. Okay, here we go, here we go. Here we go. Oh, shit, turn around. Turn around, hold on, hold on, hold on. Okay, here we go. Ah. No, no, I need to be closer. I spooked it. Yeah, I thought that's something that would attack us, but apparently I just need to hunt it. Oh, here we go, here we go. It's too far away. Ooh, ooh. Okay, I'm getting close, getting close. And... ah! Come on, cubs! Ooh, got it. Oh, does that, oh, can they all feast from it? Okay, cool, that feeds all of them. Okay, I didn't realize I could jump so far. Okay, they're all fed. Whew. All right, let's just go from the top again, beetle. Beetle, all right, you're kind of wigging out there. Come on, beetle. Oh my god, what are they doing? Beetle. There we go. And... boom! Well, I can't hold both. Alright, which one just got fed? That is Tank. Alright, so let's feed Flash next. There you go. I really like all of the different food gathering mechanics, you know, headbutt trees to get food to fall down, pick up tubers or beets or whatever they are. Actually, is a beet a type of tuber? I don't know. I don't know, but it's not important. Anyway, then, you know, grab frogs and hide in the bushes and leap out at whatever that was that I just killed. I'm actually not sure what it was. I thought it looked like a fox. Now I'm not sure. But yeah, it's just really cool that there's so many different little, like, hunting mini-games, almost. It's really nice to have that variety. Ooh, and there's a little rodent. Come here. Gotcha. Okay, Frosty. Your turn, Frosty. Where you at? Frosty. There you are. Ooh, we've got two. All right, Star. Star, you are up. And back to Beetle. Okay, something bad is definitely going to happen soon. Because it can't be this peaceful and serene forever. Whoa, look at that tree. Oh. Oh God. Hide, hide, now. Wow. Can I see them? Oh God. Oh, I just saw the shadow. I guess you do it by looking at their shadows, because you can't really look up very much. Damn. Look at that thing. Massive. Whew. Okay, come on, go. Man, I really, really like the music in the game, the way it's so responsive to what's happening. Now we've got, like, this chase sequence. Oh, God. Alright, cubs, we're gonna get through this, alright? It's gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay. Oh, we've got super cover here. See? We're all good. Look at that. We're all here. We're gonna get through this. Okay, wait for it to go past, and then we're gonna get in the log. And here we go. Come on. Ooh. That was close. Freaking hawk. I can't even see. I've got to wait for it to go past and then just run forwards. Okay, here we go. Come on. I'm guessing that I'm heading to that big tree. That looks like my destination. Come on. Where you guys at? Okay, they've got to be next to me. Okay, we've got a break here. Alright, hold on. And here we go. Come on. We got this. Ooh, which way do I go? Let's go this way. This is open. Okay, let's go. Now. Oh God. Whew. That was close. The shadow actually touched it. Okay, it seems to hone in on you. Like, it spots you. Even if it's not directly over you, it spots you and will actually, like, come back around to try to get to you. Okay, let's go. Yep, see, it's coming back around. Well, I'm in this stuff, but we're not very covered here. Okay, there we go. That's better. Okay, we're almost there. And let's go. Ooh, it's uncovered here. Oh, but is it gone? It's gone. Okay. Whew. We're okay, cubs. Beetle, Flash, Tank, Frosty, and Star, I love you. Come on, let's go. Aww. Oh, God. Oh, shit. Well, that's bad. Everyone's okay, though. Everyone's okay. They're all there. Whew. Wow. Oh, I've got this light around. Whoa. Why am I sprinting now? I'm sprinting by default now. Oh god, that does not sound good. Shit, what did I... Did something from the darkness just take one of my cubs? There's four! Which one's missing? Shit! No! Tank. Tank and... Star and Beetle and Frost... Fuck, it took Flash! Whatever it was. Is it... How did that happen? Do I need to keep my, like, cone of light around them? I mean, it started auto-sprinting me for some reason. Like, maybe when that happens, you just need to run? I don't know. It's weird. I can't even sprint now. Shit. Flash. It is not safe to be out here at night. We need to find somewhere to hole up. Alright, Beetle. Beetle, stop moving around. Beetle. Seriously? Alright, just someone eat it. Okay, there you go. Tank. I'm gonna cross Flash off of my list. Oh, no, I didn't want to have to do that. Flash. Look at that art style. It's so strange, but so good. Okay, yeah, see, now I'm auto-sprinting again. Where are they at? Where's... Did I... What the fuck? Did I just lose another one? Where... No, there it is. Wait a minute. Does that... Okay, I don't understand what's happening. So you can get lost. They can get lost. Does that mean Flash isn't dead? Hold on, we need to go back. Maybe Flash isn't dead. I just heard like a whine. Is that Flash? Flash? I hear a whining noise, but I don't know if that's Flash or what. It looks like they actually disappear out of your view. Like, when you get out of range, they actually just disappear. Flash? I don't think Flash is here. Shit. No, Flash is gone. Okay, but at least I didn't lose another one. Still, I don't understand what's happening during those sequences. You hear something coming after you, and then it forces you to sprint. Are you supposed to run away, or are you supposed to, like, make sure that they just stay within your cone of vision? I don't understand. Like, see, I'm gonna just pause for a second. The game is taking a very hands-off approach. Like, it's not hand-holdy, it's not giving you a bunch of quest markers and stuff like that, it's not telling you how to feed them, it's just assuming that you're going to, you know, just figure it out. On your own. And so far that's worked. However, it doesn't work for this. Because this is obviously a gameplay mechanic, and I don't understand this mechanic. Because the game hasn't explained it to me. I don't understand what it's doing. Like, why am I being forced to sprint? Is it trying to simulate the mother badger panicking? Or what? What's happening? I don't know. Okay, who did I feed? I fed Tank, so Beetle next. Okay, they're gonna move around like crazy again. Alright, just someone eat it. Just someone eat it, okay? There you go. Oh, Beetle actually got it. Cool. Oh, Frog. Oh god, where'd they go? There we go. Whew. Alright, you have... That's, Star. Okay, so Frosty needs to get fed next. I think I just need to keep them within my cone of vision. Ooh, there's a little one. What is that? Yeah, some sort of root. Looks like beets or some beet-like thing. Alright, Frosty. There you go. There. No, that's the wrong one. Okay, whatever. Frosty will be okay. I'll find more food. Actually, Frosty needs to be fed right now. His coat isn't looking too good. He's looking a bit gray. I suspect what's happening when you're forced to sprint is that it's simulating the mother badger panicking. So what you need to do is not panic and make sure you keep all of your cubs with you. But I can't be sure. Like, if you're not going to explain what's happening, everything needs to be intuitive. And this is not quite intuitive. Like, I get that it has something to do with something in the night coming after me. And it has something to do with panicking and keeping them within my cone of vision. I get that, I just don't know exactly what it is. There you go. Let's watch that coat go back to its full shine. There we go. Okay, where am I going? I can barely see anything. I'll just let someone eat it. I can't really distribute it too well amongst them in the dark because they're so close to me that they don't really spread out. Alright, well, we've got some cover here. Should keep us safe. And I hear a frog. Ooh, a carrot. Oh, God. Okay, here we go. So I'm sprinting, but I'm going to stay put. We're in cover, and they all can see. Did one just get taken? God damn it! I lost another badger because of an unexplained, unintuitive gameplay mechanic. God damn it! Fuck! Which one did I lose? Beetle, Frosty, and Star. So, Tank is gone. No. Crossing off Tank. I didn't think I'd lose so many this early. Jesus. So yes, you need to run. And you need to keep them within your cone of vision. I guess. I'm more scared of the unexplained gameplay mechanics than anything else. I mean, let me pause. Like, this is very frustrating. You know, if I lost my cubs because I just personally messed up and I wasn't careful enough, that would be heartbreaking. However, I'm losing my cubs because I don't understand what the game expects me to do, which is not heartbreaking, but frustrating. Like, this, that's a serious design problem, because the key of the game, the basis for it, is your relationship with your cubs, and you taking care of them. That is the entire focus of the game. So this is seriously coming between me and that. It's not working in this case. But at least now I think I know what to do, after I've lost two fucking cubs to it. God damn it. Come here. Come here. Come here. And it's gone. So if it happens, I need to go away. I need to move. It doesn't even matter if you're in cover. You need to move. But also keep the cubs in your cone of vision, otherwise they will be stuck. There you go. Beetle just got something to eat. Oh God, is it happening? It auto-sprinted for a second. Weird. All right, let's give Frosty some. If I can, there we go. And now Star. Like right there, it just force sprinted me again, and now it stopped. I don't understand why it's doing that. I can continue on, or go this way. I think this is a dead end. Yeah, that looks like a dead end. Let's go this way. Looks like Star got it. Oh, never mind. Apparently this is the dead end. There we go. Beetle got it. I wonder if you only get attacked if you stay put. Like, maybe that's supposed to be something stalking you? As long as you stay on the move, it's not a problem? Because now that I've been moving, it hasn't happened again. Gotta find somewhere safe. Somewhere where we can hole up for the night. A burrow. Whoa. What's that noise? Oh, it's a frog. I don't know if I can catch it. I can't sprint. Oh, yes, I can. There you go, Beetle got it. I think he might have gotten fed the last time. Not sure. Ah, damn it! Accidentally gave it a beetle again. Beetle is now overfed and is now suffering from obesity. Ooh, frog. There we go, Frosty. Star is next in the feeding order. There you go. Oh, being forced to sprint again. And now it's fine. I guess something was creeping up on me, and I don't know, it's kind of weird. Like, I didn't even hear anything. It's really unfortunate that I had to lose two cubs before I realized how that worked. Oh, did I get to safety? Oh, God. Freaking raining blood. Yeah, I really like how everything's so stylized. Very nice. Alright, well at least it's not dark anymore. Whoa! God. Look at those waves. That is scary. The music really is so good, just on its own, but also especially how it keeps changing and reacting to what's happening. So good. Alright. Got a rodent over here. Come here, you. There you go, Star just got fed. Let's feed Beetle next. What is that? Just a pile of nothing. Actually, that's probably where the rodent came from, isn't it? Yeah, if you scare it and you don't catch it, it probably goes back in. I wonder if you can actually be caught by those like waves of debris or whatever it is, if you're like near the bank. It kind of sweeps the bank a little bit. You might be able to get caught. Okay, let me grab this and then move. Come on, come on, come on. Be careful. Yeah, that might actually catch him. Wow. That would be horrible to have a cub or multiple cubs carried off in the water to drown. Okay, where do I go? That's closed off. Can I cross the water? Hold on, no, back up, back up, back up, cubs, come on. What's that show? Waves and rock. What was that? Waves and rock. Didn't really get a chance to look at that. Is it saying that if you hide behind the rocks, it will protect you from the waves? I sure hope that's what it said, because if not, then we're all going to die. Okay, here we go. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Okay, we should be safe, we should be safe. Okay, whew. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Ooh. We are safe here, aren't we? Right? Whew, okay, yeah. Alright, we've got some prey. Where did it go? Oh, it's all the way up there. Come on. You gotta be fast, cubs. We gotta catch him. They're gonna keep moving. That wasn't a hawk that I just heard, was it? Ooh, they're running. Did they see me? That sounds like a hawk. Or a pelican? Alright, let's not sprint. Maybe they won't run if we don't sprint. Nice and slow. Nice and slow. Didn't quite work. Oh, wow, that... Okay, that is gone. Yep. Oh, is that a little old burrow? It is. Well, okay, not a burrow, but a pathway. Is it gonna get swept away by the wave? No, okay. Can I catch fish? I doubt it. They are awfully close, though. Alright, let's go across after this wave, and let's go. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, whew. Wow. Okay. I'm just gonna let them fight about the food amongst themselves unless one needs to be fed. Cause when I let them decide which one, you know, wants to eat, it seems to work out okay. They haven't starved so far. Okay. What? What do you guys see? They seem to think there's food. Oh, is it the tree? Oh, it's the tree. There you go. Go get it, Frosty. Okay, here we go. Oh, whoa, this is gonna... Oh, God. I've gotta go up the river. That's the only way, isn't it? Up the freaking river. Oh, oh, get away from the bank! Whew, beetle, Jesus. Okay. Okay, we got this. We got this. Let's go. Okay. Come on, come on, come on. God, this is really dangerous. Come on, cubs. We're gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay. Come on, come on, come on. Come on! Okay, let's go, let's go. Okay, we're almost there. Okay, here we go. We're okay. A bunch of pretty birds just flew out of that tree. You guys have gone too long without food. Here you go. There's one for Beetle. Here is one for Frosty. I'll get one for you soon, Star. Don't worry. Ooh, here we go. There you go, Star. Okay. Fed and, well, not safe, but at least we're not at inside of a river with waves pounding at us. Oh, come on. Gonna get left behind, Star. Don't spend too long eating. Oh god, we have to go across. We do have to go across again. Ooh, frog. Okay, I think we can just make it across. Yeah, we can. Come on, come on. Come on. Come on. There we go. Okay, we're safe. Oh god. Okay, so I'm getting the impression that what's happening is basically after being separated from our home, we're kind of going through these different stages, like different snapshots of our attempts to get back home, or maybe just to somewhere safe. We're trying to find shelter, either our original shelter or just find a good one. Because obviously a lot of stuff is happening. You know, it was night, and then it wasn't, and then now it looks like we're in some sort of a forest fire zone. So yeah, I get the impression these are just like snapshots of our journey back to shelter. Which is actually a really cool setup. Okay, there's two ways to go. What's this way? Let's go up. I like high... Wait, what? Oh, apparently that's where I came from. It won't let me go there. Okay. This way it is. Well, at least there's still... at least there's still some food left. What's that noise? Birds, I think. Alright, so we're probably gonna have to worry about there we go. We're probably gonna have to worry about maybe flash fires and stuff like that. Ooh, wow. God, do we have to go through that? I sure hope not. But I think we do. Oh, God. Is it gonna keep spreading closer, or is it just gonna stay there? Oh, no, God, get away from the fire! Okay, let's go. Come on. Oh, whew. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Okay, fast, fast. Eat, 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 eat. Okay, let's go. Come on, come on, come on. stay away from flammables. Oh god, cub! You're getting really close there, Beetle. Be careful, Beetle. Come on, stay to the right. Stay to the right. Don't touch the fire. Let's stay out of the cover, I guess? Oh god, we don't have a choice here. We have to go through it. Okay, come on. Come on. Come on. Oh god, oh god, oh god. I don't like this. I don't like this. I don't like this. Oh shit. I sure hope this doesn't catch on fire behind us, because I need to stay in it. Oh god, this is gonna be really... This is not good, this is not good. Is it spreading? I don't know if it's spreading behind us or not. Okay, let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Oh, it is spreading. Where am I going? Where am I going? This way. Oh shit, go, go, go. Oh, oh! Whew. Screw the food. Go, 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 go. Oh, 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 god, oh, god. Oh, oh, oh. Shit, it's circling, it's circling. Okay, go, go, go. Fire's catching up. Come on, come on. Is it gone? No, it's not. And go, 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 go. Forget the food, go. Oh, we're safe, we're safe, we're safe. Oh, get back in cover, back in cover. Ah, oh, man, I don't... They don't need food yet. Yeah, forget the food. No, no, stay, 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 stay. Okay, and go. Okay, let's grab this. That's easy enough. Oh, shit. Ah, that is a long way to go. And go. Oh, wow. That was close. Let's grab this food. No, get back in cover. And... Ooh, that is... In cover, in cover. It's awfully close. Okay, go. Oh, god. Oh, wow. Okay, we're safe here. We're safe here. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Okay, the hawk does not seem to be here. Ooh, I think it's... Yep, it's spreading, it's spreading. Okay, go, 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 go. Come on, come on, oh god. Thankfully, the hawk is not here. Come on, come on, it is... Wow, the forest is just catching up. It going into flames behind us. Food? Let's grab it fast. Okay, come on, someone eat, someone eat, someone eat, someone eat. Okay, let's go. Come on, come on. Whew. They're all here. Beetle, Frosty, and Star. Ooh, this is open. Very open. Let's go. Let's go. Into cover. Do I need to cross? Can I cross? No. I think I'm going this way? Let's grab the food first. Was that one? That one's coat doesn't look too good. Frosty. Yeah, I think Frosty needs to be fed. Come here. Come here. Here we go. Come on, Frosty. There you go. Whoa, what the hell? They got stuck. Hello? There you go, jeez. Whew. I got scared for a second, I turned around and they just weren't there. Oh god. Grab this fast. Okay, everything is going up. This way, this way, this way, now. Come on, oh god, whoa, 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 whoa. Oh, they're in the flames. They're literally in the freaking flames. Dear God. Come on, come on. Oh God, oh God. Where's... Oh, no, 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 no. No, it's stuck behind. Come here, it's on... Shit. Is it gone? Oh no, I lost another one! Fuck! Oh. I lost Star. Got stuck behind a log. Another one crossed off my list. Star. Shouldn't have stopped for that food. God damn it. Whoa, what the hell? Wait, what? Am I seeing things, or did Star just... like, suddenly appear next to me on fire, smoking. I'm not going to complain about having Star back. Okay, I'm uncrossing you off my list. Star, you're back. Thank the freaking gods, but I don't understand. You just appeared out of nowhere on fire, in smoke. I don't understand, but I'm glad you're here. Oh, Star. Alright, well, it looks like we're away from the fire, so I think we're okay. We're okay for now. Ah. We escaped the fire. I have no idea how Star came back from the dead. Alright, here we go. Another snapshot of survival, another season. Oh, some food here. There you go. Oh, they're getting bigger. Look at that. Hell, they're about as big as me. Ah, well, I've lost Flash and I've lost Tank. But I still have Beetle, Frosty, and Star. And they're growing up, they're doing well. I'm proud of you, Cubs. Especially Star, which somehow managed to teleport out of being on fire. It's like he thought really, really hard and managed to teleport himself. Out of existence, out of the middle of the fire. And popped right next to me. Very strange. Very, very strange. Star is a special one. I guess there's a reason he's called Star. Okay, well, before I continue, I will be right back. Okay, I am back. Let's continue. Well, it doesn't look particularly dangerous so far. No fires, there looks to be plenty of food, I don't see any hawks. I'm sure it won't stay that way, but for now it's okay. Everything's going to be okay. Star, wait a minute, did I not cross one out? Oh no, I did, yeah. Star, Frosty, and Beetle. Everything's going to be okay. Look at those lovely birds. They're nice birds. Good birds. Not evil ones that want to take you away from me. Whoa, this is big. Look at this. This place is huge. Ooh. Well, my cubs definitely have good noses. They spotted that one, even I didn't. Ooh. Yes. Come on. Oh, stop running. Ooh. Ah, damn it. Spooked it. I wasn't quite close enough. Come on. Oh, really? That wasn't close enough? Alright, whatever. Here's some food. We're fine. No, get back in. You have to be closer than I thought. Oh, well, still, I mean, we have plenty of food, so it's really not an issue. I just want to catch it, though. Alright, I think it's gone. Like, can I go through here? Nah, it's gone. Damn. Yeah, we're certainly not going to run out of food anytime soon. I wonder if the fact that they're bigger actually means I need to feed them more, though. I mean, obviously in reality it would mean that, but I'm not sure if that's what it means in the game. definitely no food shortage, though. That is for sure. Look at them, they're so big. Oh god. Go, 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 go. Oh shit! Come on, come on! Oh fuck, oh fuck! Oh shit! Son of a bitch! I should have run back, shouldn't I have? Instead of forwards, I should run back into cover. Or I don't know, was there cover close enough to me? If I went back, I don't know, which one did I lose? I have Beetle and I have Star. I lost Frosty. Beetle and Star, god damn it. Well, there's two ways I can go. What's this way? Oh, just a little bit of food. Here you go. Ah, the hawk is back. Okay, where am I going? This is very, very big. I don't see anything off that way. Well, I mean, I guess I can only go where the cover is, right? Yeah, I can't just go out into the field. Oh, god. Whew. That turned awfully fast. That's a far distance to go. Okay, go, 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 go. We got this, we got this. Yeah, we're good. Okay. Okay. Yeah, I think I just need to go straight, basically. Get back in, get back in. There we go. And let's go. Okay, we're good. We're good. Everything is fine, Beetle and Star. That is an awfully close circle. Let's go. Go, 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 go. Ooh. Ooh, got a little burrow there. Any food? Nope. I don't think we need food yet. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. There we go. Whew. Okay. We're okay. We're doing okay. Did it leave? I think it left. That's good, because there's actually not very much cover out here. Not as nearly as much as before. Yeah, I don't even think this would cover us at all, would it? Whew, it's gone. Whoa. Holy shit! Run? It's not gone. Hide, hide, hide! Under. Oh god. Whoa, okay, apparently I can hit you, still. Oh god, I'm gonna die, I can't move. Shit. Can I do anything? I'm dead. God, are they grown up enough that they can find somewhere safe on their own? They sound so sad and lost. Is that what, like, can I avoid that at all, or is that supposed to happen? God, the art in this game is beautiful, isn't it? Look at that. I still don't know, though, whether that was supposed to happen and that's just the scripted end, or if I just messed up. Is there something I could have done? Yeah, that art is just gorgeous. Look at that. Yeah, I think those are actually the textures used for the game. All kind of laid out into tiles, and they are beautiful. I feel like that's probably just the scripted end to the game, and that there's nothing you can do about it, but I can't be sure. Well, let's let this play out and see if anything happens. Well, I'm pretty sure that is just the end. So I guess I'll just wrap up while it's playing through the credits. I thought I really enjoyed it. Without a doubt, I really enjoyed this game. It does have some problems. A few. So, as always, let's start with the bad so I can end with the good. I really didn't like the gameplay mechanic near the beginning of the whole something in the night is coming to eat you, because it didn't make any sense and I didn't realize how it worked until two of my cubs had been taken, which was very distressing. But not distressing in like the way the game is supposed to be, but distressing in just a frustrating way. Oh, here's the ending. Or here's the after the end. Does anything happen? Okay, that is totally how it's supposed to end. Yep. Mm-hmm. The cycle of life. What's bad for me and bad for my cubs is good for the hawk. Sad but true. Okay, I'm staring at a black screen now. Is it still recording? What's happening? Why am I staring at a black screen? Error. Oh. The game crashed. Okay. Welp. Let me start the game back up so there's something in the background for you to look at while I'm talking. Hold on just a second. There we go. Don't know why it crashed. Okay. So yeah, that is definitely how the game was supposed to end. That was definitely the scripted end and I didn't mess up. And that's a really clever ending. But anyway, back to what I was doing before. The negative stuff so I can end on positive stuff. Okay, so yeah, the gameplay mechanic of the whole something in the night is coming to eat you was very poorly done. Like, it seemed to try to communicate to you the fact that you're supposed to run by the fact that it forced you to sprint temporarily. However, that was confusing and just badly designed, because previously the game had never taken over control, ever. Like, previously, the game does not hold your hand whatsoever. It doesn't even tell you the controls. It doesn't tell you what to do, really. It doesn't have quest markers. Everything you do in the game before that, you do yourself. You choose where to walk, where to look, what to do, when to bark, when to pick up food. You do everything without any hand-holding whatsoever. Other than the little quest... Yeah, not quest things. The little tutorial tips that just tell you what you can press to do something. But you don't even have to do that. But then, all of a sudden, you have to run away from stuff, and the game tries to communicate this to you without handholding. I guess it tries to kind of not handhold you, but how it does that, and how it tries to communicate this idea that you're supposed to run, is by forcing you to sprint. So previously the game had never taken over control whatsoever, and now all of a sudden it just does it. It's completely inconsistent with everything that came previous, and was weird and confusing. And I had to lose two cubs before I even realized what the hell was happening. Apparently you need to keep on the move. I even tried staying in cover, that didn't work. You were supposed to run. Which, after the fact, now makes sense. Okay, it was forcing me to sprint, I guess that makes sense, sort of, but... I mean, if you're going to choose to be very hands-off and not hold people's hands, then you need to make sure stuff is intuitive enough that you can understand it without any help. It seems like they realized that people wouldn't understand that they had to run without any help, but how they chose to try to fix that is by forcing you to sprint, which is inconsistent with everything that happened previous and was very confusing. So yeah, that was bad. That was very bad, and I don't want to understate how important that is. It's not a minor thing, because the entire core experience of what makes this game interesting is your interaction and your protection and your... Yeah, just your interaction with your cubs. That is everything. So the fact that I lost two cubs in my confusion over the gameplay of the game is very, very bad. That is a very serious problem, so I don't want to understate just how important that is. Let's see, anything else? I think the extremely low contrast of the game is kind of weird. That's a very nitpicky thing. It's not a big deal. Because I love the art, but just the low contrast part of it is very strange. Just everything looks washed out. Not a big deal, though. Definitely not a big deal. Let's see, were there any other negatives? Dear God, that bird screaming in the background is loud. Shut up! Could turn sound off, leave music on. Any other negatives? I don't think so. Okay, I mean, well, I guess another nitpicky thing is that at the end, again, I was confused over whether I had lost the game or whether that was just the intended ending. So that's another kind of communication problem between the game and the player. Because previously, you know, you could beat everything. Right, you can hide from every hawk. But in this case, you just couldn't. It was impossible. At least I think it was. I'm pretty sure I couldn't beat that part because it looked like there was no cover. So again, the game kind of takes away control from you where previously it never has. Oh god, apparently the screaming bird is still in there even with the sound off. Okay, weird. So that was a bit weird. So you see, yeah, the game's kind of hand-holdy. It tries to be not hand-holdy, but then it also seems to be a little bit too scripted. With the whole forced sprint and the whole end you have to die thing. So that's a bit weird. The only other negative, I think, is just that the game's really, really short. Now, I'm a firm believer that... I'm a firm believer that games should not be any longer than they need to be. Like, I don't think any game should have any padding whatsoever. I hate padding. You know, I think you should explore your theme, the core idea of your game, as far as you need to fully flesh the idea out. No more and no less. So, there certainly is no filler. So that's good. However, I just wish there was more. I don't know, more interaction, more... Just more. It felt too short. Dear God, that bird is loud. I really don't understand why that's still happening, even though I turned off sound. I would turn off music, but then that's lame. Anyway. Yeah, there was no padding, but it also didn't feel like it explored the idea as much as it could have. I mean, it wasn't even quite 2 hours, and that's it. I don't know, I just would have liked to do more stuff. Alright, so that's the negatives, but as for the positives, well, there are a lot. It is a gorgeous game, with a very strange art style that I don't even know if the art style even has any particular name, but whatever it is, it looks kind of papier-mâché-y a bit, and it looks freaking beautiful. It's unique, it's really stylized, and just beautiful. Wonderful sounds. Yeah, very, very good sounds. And that oh god, the friggin' bird again, oh my god. Wonderful sounds and music. Like all the badgers, the way you can call to the other badgers, to your cubs. And the way they call back, and the fact that if you lose a certain amount, the call that you make becomes more distressed and more loud. Was a very nice touch. You know, just the wind rustling everywhere and all of those noises and the music, the way the music was just good on its own, but also the way it reacted to the changing seasons and the changing events and stuff like that. Exceptional. And I just really like the core idea of you just being a badger, a mother badger protecting her cubs. I just think that's a really beautiful idea. It's very simple. But it's wonderful. It's just a wonderful experience to be put into that role. Okay, let's see. Is there anything else? No? Alright, I think that's it. So, in summary, it's a game that has some flaws. It's overly scripted. And it feels like it didn't explore the ideas as much as it could have. But aside from that, it's beautiful. Has just a wonderful art design, wonderful sounds, wonderful music, wonderful core idea that's just beautiful. It's just such a great idea and such a great experience to just be protecting your children. I mean, it's so simple, but so beautiful and so engaging. And in the end, it's a bittersweet game, a game just like life, filled with loss, but also with gain. You know, I lost cubs, and I died, but the cubs that were left were well fed. They were happy, well, not happy, because I just died, but they were healthy. They went on to live, and even though I died, I went on to feed the hawks' chicks. So, cycle of life and all that, bittersweet, good and bad, death and life. I think it's kind of beautiful. And also depressing. Poor Tank, Frosty, and Flash. But Beetle and Star lived. Beetle and Star lived. Alright, I hope everyone enjoyed my playthrough of Shelter.